And our topic is called Earth Elixirs, Decoding the Signatures of Gem Essences. And to start, I want to just kind of cover a couple of basics about the nature of gem elixirs. Sometimes known as essences, gem waters, gem remedies, and gem elixirs. Like flower essences and other vibrational remedies, of course, they're dilute solutions that contain the energetic and spiritual blueprint of a stone. Essences or elixirs are highly potentized through the process of successive dilution. So that's going to, you know, again, parallel what we see in other streams of flower essence therapy. Now, there is a slight bifurcation here. We have things called gem waters, which can be made, you know, immediately and consumed as is, or we can turn them into essences or elixirs through that process of adding a preservative and potentizing them. So whenever anyone is inclined to make a gem water or gem elixir, we just want to make sure that something is safe to put directly in our water. And we'll circle back around to that topic just a little bit later. And when it comes to working with gem essences, a lot of the things that we see are more or less in line with traditional flower essence therapy and other similar vibrational remedies. But gems in particular tend to offer a more stabilizing and grounded energy than many flower and plant essences. You know, if our theme for this event is flower essence alchemy and getting in tune with those elemental qualities, we see them embodying that earth element so exquisitely and effortlessly. And so when we take them, they remind us to embody the earth element in a similar manner. Gem essences are also much more affordable and accessible than a lot of rare, unusual, and hard to find crystals, minerals, and gemstones. So whether you're using a commercially made one or borrowing an expensive rock to make one yourself, it gives you the opportunity to work with things that you might not otherwise have in your toolkit, like a very large, precious, perfect diamond or emerald, for example. They give us a safe internal dose of gemstone energy, and that kind of internalizing of gems as an essence really offers a kind of more intimate awareness or experience of crystal energy than maybe laying on of stones or wearing as jewelry. We can use them topically, environmentally, and in other applications, just like flower essence therapy, and they provide an alternative means for working with stones that might be unsafe to handle or wear. So again, talking about things that could be toxic, brittle, fragile, or otherwise not so amenable to regular use. So gem essences become really versatile means of broadening our horizons of both essence therapy and, you know, gemstone therapy. And it's this beautiful intersection between the two. Just kind of noting this elemental quality, if we think about the role that water plays in this, I see a strong relationship between water and crystals. And I'm sure anyone watching is probably not new to the idea that water has memory, that water retains an imprint of what it experiences or exposed to.